Over 70% of the surface of our planet is covered in water, and about 96% of all that water is held by our oceans. In the past, these oceans served as conduits which allowed people to explore every corner of the Earth. Today, they are merely seen as transportation hubs for large vessels, a proverbial dumpster for most of humanity's waste, and a place for the world's superpowers to park their very expensive war toys. But maybe there's a chance we could see these oceans serve a much bigger role in the coming years. Now, before we continue, I'd like you all to know I post new videos on Thursdays and Sundays every week, so please leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more interesting content. Many scientists today agree that people will eventually build self-sustaining habitats over and under the oceans that surround our continents. The most favored of these habitats are small connected floating cities built on land and towed to the required location. Reason being, it's simply easier constructing habitats with multiple modules made of steel, glass, and composite materials rather than trying to build one giant bubble. Wave generators built around the seastead could provide enough electricity to keep the city powered indefinitely, with large dam-like walls to dissipate the energy from large waves which would otherwise destroy the floating city. As of January last year, a deal was made between French Polynesia and the Seasteading Institute, backed by venture capitalist and PayPal co-founder Peter Thiel. The deal was to build the world's first floating city in the Pacific Ocean, just off the island of Tahiti. The plan has been in the works for the past 5 years, and construction is slated to begin as early as 2019. When completed, the floating islands would feature aquaculture farms, medical research facilities, and sustainable energy powerhouses. Now, some of you might be asking yourselves, why do we even need to bother building habitats on oceans, considering there's still a lot of landmass left for habitation? Overpopulation remains a serious and escalating issue across the globe, with an estimated figure of about 81 million people added to the world's population annually. This rapid increase in our numbers has led to an increased loss of ecosystems, including wetlands, wildlife, and rainforests, as land development for the purpose of creating living areas have become more and more intensive. There is also danger from rising sea levels. As the Greenland and Antarctic ice caps slowly melt away, the water runoff will eventually find itself in the oceans, which would pose a serious risk to coastal cities. Faced with the threat of being wiped out by the surrounding water, inhabitants of these coastal cities will be forced to choose between abandoning them or adapting. In the event of a supervolcano eruption or an asteroid impact, humanity's best chance of survival will likely involve us moving underwater, where the radiation, toxic particles, or intense heat can't get to us. Now, you may be thinking such doomsday scenarios are unrealistic, but the truth is they are very real. Scientists agree that the Earth has undergone 5 mass-level extinctions that we know of, and we are just about due for another one. Besides all the bad reasons we should strongly consider developing ocean-based colonies, there are great reasons as well. To date, scientists have explored less than 5% of the oceans, and one of the simple reasons for this is that not many people have the skills required to carry out deep-sea diving, or are willing to learn. As many sea explorers will tell you, underwater life is beautiful and full of all kinds of interesting creatures, most of which we've never seen before. Who knows, the development of large underwater habitats might be what it takes to draw people to the wonders beneath the surface of our vast oceans. Currently, there are already an array of underwater restaurants, resorts, and tours scattered across the globe. These locations are usually submerged just below the waterline, but as the interest in such sites begin to grow, we could see them go even deeper into the abyss to give people the once-in-a-lifetime experience of being in a completely different environment. In the end, the lessons we stand to learn from creating ocean-based colonies might pave the way for fully sustainable habitats in space and other planetary bodies like Europa or even Venus. I believe that alone is enough reason for humanity to take ocean colonization seriously.